is a very complex vehicle, but there's been a lot of time, patience, and intelligence put into this. So it's all led up to this final moment where we're going to take off.
After the two-hour pre-flight is completed and the plane checks out, it's taxi to the end of runway 3, and the team and I get to watch this physical manifestation of the digital thread actually take flight.
Looking towards the future, what's really got you excited as you kind of look out over the next few years?
I think the digital twin, along with the digital thread, those things together are going to revolutionize the way that not only we develop products, but the way we service products. Okay. The ability to service something in the field, for example, think about it, with your phone and taking a picture of a device and being able to 3D print that component right there on the spot is going to make servicing equipment so much faster, right?
Yeah.
It's going to change the way that we manufacture products.
That's really exciting. So it's going to be exciting.
It will be.
One of the big impacts here is how you can have a much more advanced supply chain that can rapidly meet the requirement out in the field. So what we're seeing here is a time to field a part. So this would be kind of your first iteration whenever you go about building the part via the digital thread. These are the four phases that are represented. It could take you, you know, a decent amount of time to be able to get there, faster than maybe your normal operations. But the idea is that it's not about just that first iteration. It's about the second time you go to make this and every other subsequent iteration that you go and make this, compressing that time further and further. So we're able to take down the steps that are required because I already have a model I can use from an as design perspective. I already have machine instructions I can use. I know how I'm going to certify it. I have all this data that I can reuse to make it better and better.
So it's literally facilitating a learning organization through the integration that I've developed. That's interesting.
Exactly.
Aaron, what's the last word? What's the last takeaway that I need from this?
It's the ability to use this digital thread around the globe to be able to design your product anywhere, manufacture and build your product anywhere, and sustain your product anywhere, no matter where it is, what environment it is around the world.
Terrific. Would you get on an airplane that was designed and built this way?
I think I would.
Yeah, I think honestly, it's where industry's going. I mean, you have opportunities to lightweight parts through this. You have opportunities to get even better performance from the parts. Sure, they're different looking than what we've seen previously because these are new manufacturing methods. But this is where the market's going because of the incentives of being able to produce parts this way.
Terrific.
What these new technologies do, what these new ways that we use data to design new airplanes faster, better, cheaper, simply is a night and day difference. It changes the how, the what if, the all of those questions that would have had an iterative cycle of weeks or months into seconds, minutes, hours, perhaps.
Because I've already got it there in my repository, in this body of knowledge I have about the existing.
So the first is because you've got it there to work with. And now you take that next unique idea and you say, what if this? But you get to do in nearly real time design changes. It flows into the analysis. There's a way to look at the manufacturing impact. You know the conflicts and how the part fits into other things. This is where the world really changes.
We've only just begun to imagine the power of what this will unleash. We've focused a lot on how it improves the design process, speed to market. So that's goodness for the engineers, that's goodness for the consumer. But I also see the digital thread really improving the manufacturing process in real time and be able to get real time improvements so they can continue to improve the way they operate, either be through efficiency or otherwise.
Who's gonna get there first, right? What organizations, what companies are going to be out in front and capture the productivity bumps, if you will, or improvements that are available via this technology or set of technologies? That's going to give them a competitive advantage right here, right now.
So there you have it. Our bell crank is taking off, but it remains in the digital thread. Information collected as this part is used will feed back into the system and inform everything from when maintenance is needed to what design tweaks can be implemented the next time out. We want to remember that the digital thread is not just about a single airplane part. It's about all different kinds of parts in many different industries. The digital thread is about integrating a suite of technologies to create that single, seamless strand of data and computing power that stretches across boundaries throughout the life cycle of a component. It's about designing, building, inspecting and monitoring components in pursuit of value.